Hey folks, good morning. Ray Gano here, PZTV, and it's Coffee with Ray. I want to share with you some profound words that have basically affected me for a long time. And it's a saying by Chuck Colson. And in fact, here, let me actually play it for you. It is the first part of a song from Stephen Curtis Chapman, Hope in the Real World. But these words have just had profound impact on me, my life, and the prophesying ministry. And basically is asking, where is the hope?
A report out today says that the number of gang members have increased 65% in the past year.
Residents once again today in Northern Ireland with the
in other news,
of
the Drug Enforcement Agency seized 20 kilos of pure cocaine
again to help get food.
Where is the hope? I meet millions who tell me that they feel demoralized by the decay around us. Where is the hope? The hope that each of us have is not in who governs us or what laws are passed or what great things we do as a nation. Our hope is in the power of God working through the hearts of people. And that's where our hope is in this country. That's where our hope is in life.
So where is the hope? I find it interesting coming back to the United States, like I said before, and it just seems like everybody, all they're doing is just bickering. And where's the hope? I mean, what are we doing? Why aren't we sharing the hope? I mean, look at everything that's going on. We have the prime opportunity to stop this foolishness, stop this stupid bickering, fighting and arguing over stupid things. I mean, things of little value, things of little concern. I mean, who cares if the earth is flat? Who cares what the timing of the rapture is? Who cares about a lot of these things that seem to be dividing us? I don't understand. And it's amazing to me that people would rather bicker than share the hope and be able to share the hope effectively. It's, you know, instead of fighting the enemy, we fight each other. And so this is just something that troubles me. And we're living in an era of no hope. People globally have been stripped of the knowledge of God. I mean, it's amazing to me. I was watching this one video one time where this guy was asking this, I think probably, you know, first, second grader showing her pictures of people. You know, who's this person? Who's that person? Well, she knew J-Lo and she knew, you know, all these famous celebrities and everything. But when a picture of Jesus Christ was presented to her, she didn't even know who he was.
I'm going to show you some pictures and I want you to tell me who they are.
Okay.
Who's that? You don't know?
George Washington.
Yeah? Who is he?
He was the fourth president who freed the slaves.
And he could never tell a lie.
Who's that?
I don't know.
You don't know?
I don't know.
George W. Bush?
No, that's a good guess, though.
And that, folks, is sad. You know, it's... Where's the hope? Why aren't we doing our job? Why have we forgotten how to share the gospel? You know, the world is in perilous times because they don't have hope. Because they don't, you know, we don't have hope because I think we've lost our faith. You know, a lot of people, oh no, I haven't lost my faith. If you haven't lost your faith, then why aren't you sharing the hope? If we truly are living in the last days of the last days, why aren't you sharing the hope? I mean, if you believe that the rapture can happen tomorrow, how many in your family right now do not know the Lord? And what are you doing about it? Why aren't you sharing the hope? Is it more important to you get on these forums and Facebook and everything and bicker and argue about who's right and who's wrong over a rapture or over the flat earth, round earth, or all these other myriad of topics that we can argue over it? You know, we have a chance here, folks, to renew the hope. I mean, look at what's going on fact, just last night, yesterday, look what happened with Comey. I mean, like it or not, people, Trump was vindicated. And in fact, Comey is a lawbreaker. And that guy needs to be arrested, plain and simple. But, you know, we have a new hope in our nation going on right now. But instead of petering it away and doing nothing with it, why are we not doing something and share the hope? There's, you know, we need to renew our faith. But to renew our faith, we need to renew our minds. I'm reminded of Romans 12:2, and it says, "Be not conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind, that you may prove that what is good and acceptable unto the Lord." So how do we renew our minds? We renew our minds by being in God's Word. And it's God's Word that gives us power. It's God's Word that recharges our batteries or strengthens what I call our force field or something. You know, I watch too much Star Trek or something. But if we are able to renew our minds, it renews our faith, it renews our hope. And hope is what people need today. They need hope that no other can give, and that person is Jesus Christ. Our only hope is in the power of God working through the hearts of people. That is one of the lines that Chuck Colson was saying, and I totally agree with it. There's not enough people, you know, doing God's work. Instead of taking time to share the hope, they're taking time to just argue and bicker. Was it 1 Peter 3:15 is probably one of my more favorite verses in the world. And Ray paraphrases, says, "Always be ready to share the hope that's within you and in meekness and fear." I often add to that, in good times and in bad. Always means always. Always be ready to share the hope that's within you. And so that means always be ready to share it in bad times, always be ready to share it in good times, always be ready to share it. Be ready. And yet people aren't ready. And this is one of the reasons why I do preparedness, and I am prepared, and I constantly work at my preps and everything, so that these are things that I don't have to worry about, so I don't have any distractions. You know, oh man, I got to go grocery shopping, or oh man, how am I going to do this? Oh man, how am I going to do that? I have these preps in hand so that I don't have these distractions. Why? So that when the opportunity presents itself to share the hope, I'm able to do that. And that's why being prepared, that's why having food on hand, water on hand, all these things on hand, these are inexpensive forms of hope insurance or security insurance, if you want to call it. I don't have to worry about these things because I have them on hand already. And so I'm free to share the hope. And by sharing that hope, it's can be as little as just giving someone a listening ear. Or another thing, and I see this coming here soon, is being able to take your neighbor that extra bag of rice or a dozen eggs or a loaf of bread. And you know, that neighbor might be hurting. You're sharing the hope. Sometimes sharing the hope is a willingness to pray with someone because they have nowhere else to turn. And the thing that we need to remember is that we are living in perilous times right now. Perilous times are here. They're not, you know, when perilous times are coming. No, perilous times are here right now, right this point and moment. And we have a chance to make a difference. But to do that, we need to have faith in things hoped for. They need to have our minds renewed through the Word of God and be in fellowship with God, not bickering and arguing with each other. When we're prepared and we're renewed, it's times that God then presents people an opportunity to us that we can then share the hope. And that's what I'm getting at, is that we need to be able to share the hope. My hope one day is to face the Lord and have Him tell me, "Welcome to my kingdom, my good and faithful servant." And that is what I'm working for, is that's why I share the hope, because I want to hear Christ tell me that there is hope. And I want to encourage you folks today to stop this bickering, stop this infighting, stop this petty crap. I mean, this petty needling, and, you know, majoring on such minor issues. It's just ridiculous. And it's a waste of time. We need to be sharing the hope, folks. So where is the hope? The hope is the power of God working in the hearts of men and women like us. We have that chance to share that hope. And that hope is Jesus Christ. And we need to share the hope. Thanks for joining me. Coffee with Ray.
PZTV.